In this video, we're going to start the CUDA software Infinite Geometry free worksheet Reflections. This is just another transformation worksheet, so I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. In numbers 1 through 6, we are going to graph the image of the figure using the transformation given. So in number 1, it tells us that we have a reflection across the y equals negative 2. So I'll start by finding the y equals negative 2, which is highlighted in green. Now, for reflecting across that axis, we're only going to be changing the y values. Think of it as a mirror. We're not going to be shifting our figure at all, but we're going to be flipping it. So we're changing in the y direction. Now, since I is on the axis, when that gets reflected, it will still stay. So I and I prime are in the same location. Now let's look at E. E is one away from our y equals negative 2 line, so it'll be one away, just in the opposite direction, since it's a reflection. So here, we'll have E prime. And then, next, we'll go to Z. Z is 1, 2, 3, so stemming from that same point where we moved 3 down from, we will now move 3 up. So here is Z prime, and then same with Q. If we start at this point on the y equals negative 2 axis and go 1, 2 points down, then Q prime will be 1, 2 points up from that same spot. So here is Q prime, and then we will connect our points to form our quadrilateral. I was connected to Q, so I will be connected to Q prime. Z was connected to Q, so Z prime to Q prime. E was connected to I, so E prime to I prime, and E prime to Z prime. Let's move on to number 2. In number 2, we have a reflection across the x-axis, which the x-axis, think of it as y equals 0. So again, we're going to only be changing the y values of our coordinates. So if we're reflecting across the y equals 0 line, the x-axis, then A, drawing a straight line to that axis, 1, 2, 3, is 3 steps away. So it will be 3 units away in the other direction. So here we will have A prime. D is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 units away. So it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 units away for D prime. Same with M. M is 5 units away. So staying with that same x value, since we're not changing the x direction, M will still be negative 1. But as opposed to being a positive 5, M prime will be negative 1, negative 5. And W, negative 1, 1, 2, 3, 4 steps away. So it'll be negative 1, 1, 2, 3, negative 4 steps away. W prime. So connecting W prime to M prime, W prime to A prime to D prime, and then M prime to D prime. That's our quadrilateral reflected across the x-axis in number 2. In number 3, we have a reflection across the y equals negative x line. So y equals negative x, that's going to be a negative slope. If x is negative 5, y is positive 5. If x is negative 4, y is positive 4. And so on. If x is 0, y is 0. And if x is positive 5, then y is negative 5. Now, when we're reflecting, S is 1, 2, 3, 4 points right of the origin and 2 points up. So reflecting that, we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4 points down from the origin and 2 points over. And to note, if we were to draw a line from S to S prime, our new point, that line would be perpendicular with the reflection line. So here, we have S prime. Looking at A, so think of that line going perpendicular to our reflection line. Here, we will have A prime. And then J, if we drew a line perpendicular to our reflection line and went the same distance, we would have J prime. And then same with T, perpendicular. Here, we would have T prime. And it's very useful to have a grid when dealing with reflections, since we can see that point J lies on the intersection of those grid lines. J prime will also lie on the intersection of those grid lines, just reflected across that line. So now I'll just connect S prime to A prime to J prime to T prime, and then S prime to T prime. In number 4, we have a reflection across the y equals negative 1 line. So we know now that as opposed to changing x and y like we did in number 3, we're only going to be changing our y values since we're reflecting over that y line. So let's look at point B first. B is 1, 2 below the line, so B prime will be 2 above the line. Next we'll look at I. I is 1, 2, 3 units above, so I prime will be 1, 2, 3 units below. L is 1 below, so L prime will be 1 above. And W is 1, 2, 3, 4 above, so W prime will be 1, 2, 3, 4 below. Now we'll connect I prime to W prime, L prime to W prime, B prime to I prime, and lastly B prime to L prime. There is our reflected quadrilateral in number 4. In number 3, we're going to be reflecting across the x equals negative 3 line. So finding x equals negative 3 and drawing that line, you can see that now as opposed to changing vertically, we're going to be changing horizontally since we're reflecting over an x line. So w is 1 to the right, therefore w prime will be 1 to the left. S is 1 to the right, so s prime will be 1 to the left. But note, I'm not changing the y values. S and S prime are still both positive 1 in the y direction, and W prime and W are both 3 in the positive y direction. I is 2 to the left, so I prime will be 2 to the right. And lastly, P is 1 to the left, so P prime will be 1 to the right. Now I will connect those to form my quadrilateral. P prime to I prime, S prime to P prime, W prime to I prime, and then S prime to W prime. And you can see that it is indeed a mirror image over x equals negative 3. And lastly in this video, I'll go over number 6. We're reflecting across the y equals x line. So when x is negative 5, y is negative 5, when x is 0, y is 0, and when x is 5, y is positive 5. If we were to draw a line perpendicular to y equals x, coming from point P, we would be able to find P prime, since it will be the same distance away. So here we will have point P prime. Q, drawing that perpendicular line, we will have Q prime. And also note that each of these points intersects grid lines. So Q is one grid line intersection and a half. So we go half and another one grid line intersection to get to Q prime. And I can do that because I know that that would fall on my perpendicular line. Next, looking at H, drawing our perpendicular line, H is 1, 2, 3 intersections away, so 1, 2, 3 intersections away will be H prime. And lastly, L is only one intersection away, so following along that perpendicular line, going one intersection away, that will be L prime. And note that that distance that L is not one unit away from that reflection line, because one unit is the length of the legs of the triangle. So 1 squared plus 1 squared equals 2. A squared plus B squared equals C squared. So if A squared plus B squared equals 2, the square root of C squared will equal the square root of 2. So C will equal the square root of 2. However, L is that square root of 2 distance away, and L prime is the same. So now I'll have to connect each of my points. P was connected to L, so P prime will be connected to L prime. P was also connected to Q, so P prime to Q prime to H prime, and then L prime to H prime. And with that, we wrap up this first section of this worksheet. Join me in the next video where I'll finish this worksheet completing numbers 7 through 12. If you have any comments, leave them below, and if you haven't already, like, subscribe, and share.